Today I'm going to talk about yarn bowls. Everyone's been making these lovely little yarn bowls, and I want to show you how I make a yarn bowl from start to trim to cut to finish, but I'm not going to knit a thing. Anyway, so I always like to throw on a wet bat. If you want to know more about this part, I do talk about it a lot more in the casserole video. I'm going to put on a little ball of clay, a bit of tude. I'll turn my wheel on, it'll go faster, and I'm going to center. And I'm going to do this quickly. When I'm centering, I'm just going to push. I'm right-handed. I'm going to push the clay up and push the clay down. And it's a gentle, I call it dance between. As I'm pushing the clay up, my hand is supporting down. As I'm pushing down, my hand is supporting up. And it's this back and forth transfer of pressure that puts this little guy on the wheel. You want to make sure, we'll talk more about this in another video. You want to make sure you do get some movement though. And that movement will put it on. And you don't have to use brute force. You can use the force of the wheel and up and down. So okay, so now I've got it centered. Sometimes it's a little messy there, you can get rid of that. And then I'm just going to center it, always making sure it's slidey and moist. I'm going to just open up. My left hand stays where it was, my right hand goes in. And you want to be careful you don't go all the way down to the bottom. We talk about thick bottoms and thin bottoms in other videos. I'm going to pull my finger. All I'm doing is I'm pulling my fingers, my right fingers to the palm of my left hand. And this is one movement where you get a lot of height. Pull it up and push up. So all I did was I went across and then up at an angle, keeping that cone shape. You don't make a bowl. This doesn't make a bowl until I say it makes a bowl. So I'm just going to make a quick little bowl, always keeping it moist. When I'm pulling up, my inside hand is a little bit below my outside hand. They come together and they get almost together at the top. So as I said, this is not about throwing, it's just about making, if that makes any sense at all. I'll talk more about, we're gonna do some other videos on the how to throw. So I'm just gonna pull this out into a little bowl. Clean it up. Compacted a bit. Now it's got kind of an odd shape. I'm just gonna bring it in together. Check that without it, tiny tips of the clay teacher. It's a quick little bowl. And the nice thing about yarn bowls, if they aren't exactly true, you're gonna cut holes in it and no one's ever gonna know but you. That's a funny little bowl. Anyway, there's a little bowl. So I'm gonna cut this off. And when we come back, I'll trim a bowl, obviously not that one, and we'll talk about trimming. I threw the little bowl, it's not this bowl, but I'm going to trim it and turn it into a yarn bowl. Anyway, I always like to trim on a wet board or bat, and you can take your bowl off and put it on there, but it's just easier to sandwich it, and then that way you don't beat it up too much. And this, I'm going to scrape that off of there. And I'm going to put it on a wet board, and all this is messy and dry from throwing yesterday. I'm just going to moisten it up and it'll be ready to go when I am. You can just sit there, drink that moisture and wait. Okay, I'm going to center this quickly. First of all, you have to make sure it's level, that it's not sitting higher or lower. These bats aren't all that level, and I'm not saying my throwing is perfect. So I'm going to just touch it there. You see, it touched here and didn't touch there, so this side has to be lowered. Very high-tech way of lowering things. And now it touches all the way around, so it's level. The next one, I want to make sure it's centered. It will scratch the needle, the furthest part that's away from center. Since it's the furthest part away from center, I'm going to gently push it to center. And I never learned to do that tapping thing. Some people can do that. Some people can't. I've never used one of those Giffen grips or griff, whatever they're called. I just always have done it this way. Sometimes it goes quicker than others. And that's close enough. Okay, now I'm just going to quickly trim this, but I'm going to trim this on purpose to thin, and you'll see why in a minute. I'm using a trimming tool. I like this trimming tool. It's a Kemper R4. I've used this type of tool for the last years. Decades. I just like this one. I'm used to it. I'm just going to trim this off. To find a foot. Tidy it up. I like to undercut a little bit. I think it makes a nicer line to your bowl. It gives it a presence on the table that says, I'm sitting here. And also, I do a lot of different colors and glazing, and if you have this on here, if you don't want to turn it upside down and dip the rim into something else, you got something to hang on to. Okay, and I did that for, check out three handmade tools for thickness. I'm going to purposely trim this one too thin. And I'll show you in a bit just how come. Because we were talking about tiny tips from the clay teacher, and I showed you, well, that was rude. I showed you how to thicken a bottom when you are throwing it. But sometimes if you're trimming, you might get a little carried away and trim too much out of there. A good way to know if you trim too much out of there is you do this. When you can hear it and it starts to wiggle back and forth, it's very thin. Gonna go a little bit further. I would not normally trim this deep. Now, you see it starts to move a bit. And you'll see when we turn it over that it's gonna look kind of messy. Okay, so now I'm going to tidy it up. I always sponge. When you're sponging your pot, what it does is it brings out the little particles. Clay is a con- we'll talk about that in another movie. In another video, it is bring out these little particles. You never want to see where your trimming ends and your throwing starts. You want it to all look the same. I'm going to go back to this board. It's had some time to soften up. Scrape it tidy. Notice this, my pots are tidy. My table, not so much. And I'm going to have another little piece of paper. I always like to work on roll ends. Well, not the whole roll end, just a little piece of it. And I'm going to moisten this piece. Moisten the paper. I've talked about this in other videos. Because sometimes when you put the wet pot on the board, it'll stick back on. And you've got it all tidy now and you have to cut it off again. It's just unpleasant. Okay, so now I've got that bottom too thin. I'm going to turn it over. As I mentioned, I like this way of doing it because you don't really have to touch the pot. Now you can see inside it's all sort of poked up a little bit, and it's very thin. I'm going to lift it, let the little bit of air out of there. It's really thin. This pot could not go through life for very long. Check out Tiny Tips from the Clay Teacher, easy for me to say, and you'll see what I'm going to do. You don't have to thicken the bottom only in throwing. Oh, maybe I have to center that a little bit, though. And I'm going to, another tiny tip is I'm going to put marks on here with the sponge because I've got the outside all tidy. And if I start centering with the needle, it will make it messy. So I quite often, when I'm finished trimming, don't use the needle to make marks, but I may use the sponge. That's close enough. And it doesn't have to be perfectly centered. As I mentioned before, pots are like people. Very few of us are perfect. It should be more centered. But I am fussy. Where'd that go? There it is. Okay, that's good enough right there. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a little bit of moisture on there. And I have a little pancake made like I did on Tiny Tips from the Clay Teacher. I'm going to put this in here. So you don't have to do it when you're throwing. If you trim your bottom too thin, all is not lost. Again, you can just put the bottom in like we did in the tiny tips. going to take it out to the edge, not all the way to there. Take my needle, get rid of the excess, and didn't go all the way through. Get rid of the excess, and we can blend that in the same way we did when we were doing it when we were throwing. The only thing is when you do this, you will lose some definition on that tidy foot you put on there. It'll squish out, but that doesn't really matter. I guess if you wanted to, you could wait till this got leather hard and retrim it, but it's just a bowl. So there we are. So now it was trimmed too thin, but I've saved my bowl. So now this little bowl, I'm going to turn it into a yarn bowl. A lot of times when people are making yarn bowls, they get these sort of really weird, convoluted J things. And when I find it a problem getting my head around inside, outside, where the yarn's supposed to go, and cutting the thing. When I first started making them, they got very large and weird. I found an easier way, and this is how I do it. I just have these hole punch, and I'm going to go down about there. There's no really right way or wrong way. And I'm going to cut a hole. And take that out. Don't worry about the inside right now. And then I'm going to, with just a knife, this is a sharp little paring knife, cut just a little kind of a swooping line, I guess you'd call it, into there. And then another little swooping line. This is a little soft. That's okay. So then I just have these swooping lines. And I have another hole punch, and I like it just because of the look of it. I give it three little holes. Work with me. I'll do one on the top, one on the bottom, or one on the bottom, one on the top, and then one kind of in the middle. Now when you look at this, the inside's going to be really messy. You probably get that from above. So what I do is I just smear it all into the hole. Just smear it in, fill it in, and smear it that way. And then go back at it from this way, and it makes it tidier. So this one I just trimmed it. It is a little soft. I normally give it a little longer than that before I start cutting on them. But there you have your yarn bowl. You don't have to decide with your that was rude. You don't have to decide with your convoluted J where things end. You have a nice, the knitter has the option of running the yarn through or staying in one of these bigger holes, one of these closed holes. And like I said, it's a bit soft, sponge it up. Make it tidy. I'll sponge it up a bit more. Sometimes when I'm sponging, my clay is quite toothy and it will leave gritty bits in there that I think could snag the yarn. So what I do right before I fire, when after it's bisque, is I will sand if it looks really coarse, and that way if the little bits of sand break through the glaze, they're not going to snag someone's yarn. So that's it. It's just a basic little hole, swoopy line, and three little holes for decoration, and that's how I cut the yarn bowl.